Ladies and gentlemen, our program will begin in about 20 seconds, so please take your seats and enjoy your evening. And now, everyone, please welcome to our stage Patricia Glaser Shea, President and CEO of the YWCA of Nashville and Middle Tennessee. Welcome, Patricia.
Good evening. Good evening, everybody. On behalf of the YWCA and our presenting sponsor, First Tennessee, welcome to the 21st Annual Academy for Women of Achievement. I am so pleased that you are all here tonight. As we know, women's voices change the world. This evening, it feels like the YW's work in lifting women's voices, past, present, and future, are converging. First, tonight the YW is honoring six women in one organization whose voices have changed Nashville, making it a better place for all of us to live. Second, this fall, the YW is celebrating their 114th anniversary. It's a long time. 114 years of providing relevant services to protect and lift women up. Last year, through our domestic violence program, GED services, youth mentoring, and other services, we helped thousands of women and girls find and share their voices. Recently, our country celebrated the 92nd anniversary of the passing of the 19th Amendment, giving women the right to vote. For decades, our foremothers, along with the YWCA, fought so we would have that privilege. Here locally, a young Tennessee representative, Harry Byrne, listened to his mother's powerful voice urging him to vote for suffrage. Breaking what had been a tie, Harry's change of heart made Tennessee the deciding state, giving women the right to vote. A week from now, we go to the polls to use our voices once again. And it has been suggested to me that women need to vote, as there are many women's issues on the table. However, I beg to disagree, because all issues facing our nation are women's issues, and we women can really make a difference. So please now join me in listening to another woman's powerful voice, reminding us in song of the wonderful country in which we live, and how each of us can use our voice, our vote, to be part of this amazing democratic process. Welcome, Michelle, a truly inspiring woman and an extremely talented musician.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber ways of grain, for purple mountains, majesties above the fruited plain. On thee and crown thy good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea. America, America, God shed his grace on good with brotherhood from sea to shining sea.
Wow. Michelle, that was extraordinary. Thank you so much for that amazing performance and all that you do for the YWCA. I'm overcome. That's amazing. Way to go. Now let me introduce you to our wonderful MC for this evening, News Channel 5 Emmy Award-winning and everybody's favorite meteorologist, Leland Statham. Thank you, Leland, for joining us for the sixth straight year and for being part of a special night. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Pat, and it is great to be back, to be part of such a tremendous celebration of women in our community. So are y'all ready for a great time tonight? It is definitely good to be back. It's also great to be here with a room full of the city's best and most beautiful women. My wife has taught me well, all right? And a few of you guys also, all right? Right now, we want you to please continue eating your salads and your desserts, if you so please. We will move forward with our program, and dinner will be served immediately following. Each year, the Academy for Women of Achievement honors a Middle Tennessee company that demonstrates a commitment to the advancement of women. This year, the YWCA is pleased to present Skanska as the 2012 AWA Corporate Honoree. Company executives recognize the benefits and perspective that women bring and acknowledge that in order to be successful in today's market, it must reflect the communities in which it operates. Skanska knows that to be more inclusive and diverse, the company has to make sure that it is in a great position to attract top talent. The influence of women is felt throughout the company with their promotion of women in leadership roles and emphasis on mentoring relationships. Please join me in watching a short video about Skanska.
Skanska is a global, publicly owned design and construction company based in Stockholm, Sweden, primarily operating through Europe, North America, and South America. Now over 125 years old, Skanska employs nearly 55,000 people, but its size and scope is perhaps not as impressive as its culture and core values.
We build virtually everything. We do a lot of infrastructure projects, underground bridges, buildings, stadiums, hospitals. Safety is our primary concern and our first core value, followed closely behind inclusion, good corporate citizenship, protecting the environment, being a great place to work.
When I started with Skanska in 1996, we had very few females in leadership positions. That's simply the nature of our business. Construction has long been a male-dominated industry, but we've worked really hard and continue to work hard on having females in leadership positions. Our executive to leadership program, our Skanska Female Mentor Program, where emerging female leaders are partnered with members of our senior leadership team?
We have a couple of things that we do at Skanska that encourage young women to get in the construction industry. There's a national program called the ACE program. We were one of the early chapters here in Nashville to embrace that program.
We have a rotation program at Skanska that allows young leaders to experience different parts of our companies in a two-year rotation. So they work in every part of our business for 4 months over the course of the 2 years. So that allows them to understand how the company works and really decide what they want to do with their career.
Why is it a smart business decision to embrace girl power and promote opportunities for women? It adds to the real value of who you are as a company. Inclusion is the journey and diversity is the destination.
Women bring a different perspective to the table and understand that your opinions and your thoughts are valuable.
The ultimate goal is when it's a cultural thing, when the people in the company embrace it, then it's not a program, then it's not something you print and hand out.
For me personally, I have a 7-year-old son, and the ability to have a flexible schedule and maintain work-life balance. Skanska is a company that really understands that and appreciates that.
Being chosen for the YWCA's corporate honoree is a tremendous honor. Being acknowledged that this is a good place for women to come and work and grow and flourish means that we're doing some good work, and that might make us work even harder in the future.
It is a great honor to introduce you to Claire Gaume, YWCA Board Chair, and Rita Mitchell, Senior Vice President of First Tennessee, our presenting sponsor. Apparently, they've got a crowd in the house, too. Doral Rippey, Nashville President of First Tennessee, is also with us tonight. So please join them in congratulating Skanska's Co-Chief Operating Officer, Joy Hatch, on this great achievement. Again, thank you all very much and congratulations. It is with much excitement that we recognize our 2012 individual honorees. Six amazing and inspiring women representing a diverse and broad spectrum of Middle Tennessee. Take our first honoree, Stacy Garrett. Each January for the past 10 years, Stacy has chaired a special event hosted by her law firm to honor the life and the legacy of Martin Luther King Jr. It is no exaggeration to say that Stacy Garrett lives the mission of the YWCA every day, championing the efforts to eliminate racism and to empower women.
I was shocked. I was floored. I didn't think that of all of the incredible women here in Nashville, that I would be recognized with the other women. It was an incredible, incredible honor. My grandmother is someone who was just a lot of fun. She taught us all to dream big and have lots of fun. You never know how my grandmother would come to pick you up, so whether she was gonna throw the helmet at you and pick you up on a motorcycle, and I mean, she was in her, you know, mid-60s then. My grandmother instilled the spirit of fun, yes, to keep everything lighthearted, but to not let anybody or anything make you believe that you couldn't do absolutely everything that you dreamed of. The accomplishment that I'm most proud of is co-founding Beau McAllister Norton, my law firm. I think we have a great firm, and we've really tried to foster doing good in the community, and that's been very meaningful to me. Recently, I have, for Special Olympics of Tennessee, rappelled down our building, but I am really afraid of heights, so I rappelled down 27 floors. It was the first time I'd ever done it. The moment I climbed over the building and kind of had that realization of what other people go through and how difficult it is to overcome your fears. That was a turning point for me. My mother was my best friend, so I spoke to her. I spoke to her probably 6 or 7 times a day, every day. In the last year of her life, her strength that she showed me will probably be the single most lasting impression I have. She kept a smile on her face. She still loved to have friends over, and she insisted on doing her big parties, and she would greet everyone there, and she found joy in everybody. Understanding that has meant a lot to me, and I think I've learned a lot from it. I practice higher education law and corporate law. I represent also a lot of people who are immigrating to the United States. That's a rewarding part of my practice because it gives me an opportunity kind of to interact with a lot of different people. Practicing law was not my first career option. In fact, I think I had 2. One was that I was pretty certain that I was going to be an astronaut. The other career option I thought about was to join the CIA. I'd taken French for 12 years and was very fluent, and thought I should be in the CIA and work in Northern Africa. What brings me peace is my faith. Joy are my family and friends. The lasting impression I hope I leave, I hope that I'm able to do random acts of kindness that bring peace to someone or bring them joy. And so I hope that those acts of peace and joy I'll be remembered for.
Wow, so much enthusiasm for life. What a positive energy and an inspiration to all to make a difference. So congratulations, Stacy. Our next honoree, Mary Schlater Stumm, has been giving her support to others for over 6 decades. In the words of our co-chair, Mary Lee Bartlett, one of Mary's greatest gifts is to work behind the scenes to empower others, especially women, to rise to their fullest potential.
When my friend Mary Lee Barton called me to tell me I had been chosen to do this, she told me she was going to be the chair with Grace O in this event, and I thought she was kind of asking me to help her in some way. So I didn't really catch on right at first, but I was very, very honored. We needed a children's hospital in Nashville for a long time, and the Junior League home originally was mainly for children with polio and that type thing that took a lot of rehab. Then the children who came there had more serious problems. So that was one of the reasons for starting a children's hospital and incorporating the Junior League home into it. Anything I've ever done has been part of a team, so I just happened to be at the right person at the right place. My father died when I was 4 years old, and a couple years after that, my mother remarried, which of course changed my whole life. And I have a wonderful second father. His name is Albert Rose, and he was a wonderful father to me. The people who've made the most difference or lasting impressions in my life would be my mother and my grandmother and my husband Paul's mother. All of them dealt with lots of problems in their lives, but they did it with grace and always loved life and went forward with life, even though they had some difficulties. I was very blessed to be born into a wonderful family and very blessed to marry into a wonderful family. My children are wonderful, as are their spouses and all of my grandchildren. I am very naive in some things, and I told a joke at the dinner table once when they were small, and my husband said, "Mary, you do not understand that joke. Do not tell it again." I read Mrs. Cheap every day, by the way. I'm a big coupon person. But she wrote last year, said, "If someone were to give you $500, what would you do with it?" And so I responded that I would match it with my own money and divide it among my 13 grandchildren and let them pick something they were passionate about to give them unto. It was so much fun for me to see each of them pick something that they were passionate about and that needed the money. That brought me great joy. I want to skydive. I want to ride in a hot air balloon. I believe that God has a plan for us. And I believe I have been extremely, extremely a lucky girl in my life.
Congratulations, what an amazing example to our children and grandchildren and to all of us in the community. And maybe we'll inspire all of us to go skydiving one day. There are a number of things that must come together to make a night like this successful other than my carefully coordinated outfit. Oh, wait a minute. They wrote that, I didn't, all right? Tremendous honorees are certainly at the forefront, as well as fabulous chairs to make this night a reality. We are proud to recognize our 2012 AWA chairs, Grace O and Mary Lee Bartlett. All right. Right now we're going to ask Grace and Mary to stand right now to be recognized. We truly appreciate your hard work, support, and commitment to this event over the past 10 months. Also, a very special thanks, and for the Marcy, you didn't write this, but this is an add-on here. A special thanks and shout out to the YWCA Advancement Team who have worked so hard to make this evening very special for all of us. As I call your name, either stand or wave, Donna Dant. Marcy Smeck. Anna Tafel. And Caitlin O'Leary. And that special shout out comes from your boss, and you know when the boss asks you to do something, you go ahead and do it, all right? But she wanted to make sure that you all were recognized. She knows that you all have put in a tremendous amount of time and hard work in this, and she wanted to make sure that you got your flowers while you could understand and receive them. So congratulations again to you. As always, we are so grateful to our corporate sponsors who invest so much time and money to advance the causes of the YWCA. Tonight we will honor your contributions in song. Let us take you back. Take you back to the days of platform souls. Well, I call them stacks, all right? Big hair from me that was trying to have the Michael Jackson afro. Even cornrows, if you could find pictures. When disco and dance music rule the airways. Right now, we want to recognize our sponsors. First Tennessee, MP&F, Dollar General, the Tennessean, and DVL. This is our tribute to you.
Well, you can tell by the way you spin that stuff. You're the PR firm, you don't do fluff. Big on firm in Tennessee, and they're helping out the wife for free. We're 65. You can look the other way. Clients come, big or small, and then those politicians come. Whether they're a liberal leaning to the right, we'll stay in the fight, stay in the fight. Even when they're putting their foot in their mouth, you're pulling it out, pulling it out. Mick, Neely, Pitt and Fox, Mick. Future of the printing of never died. People getting news online, new subscriptions fell behind, and that darn internet meant the news was redefined. But now they're back from that dark place. They've rebranded and commanded how to get back in your face. There's still paper, but there's Twitter, Facebook, Google, all online. And the best part is they're still giving to the Y. Go on now, go! The Tennessean reinvented, they've cemented that they're still the place to be. They'll do more than just survive. They are gonna thrive, they will thrive. Oh yes, they'll thrive. Go on now, go! The Tennessean reinvented, they cemented that they're still the place to be. Readership is on the rise. They'll do more than just survive. They're gonna thrive. Oh, they'll thrive. The Tennessean.
Gotta get away from those high-priced shopping malls. Gotta find a place where the discounts are so small.
She's a shopaholic, 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 shopaholic.
Talk about
saving.
Gotta come back,
Dollar General.
I can't do that,
Dollar General.
Cut me some slack,
Dollar General.
Everybody clap with us.
Than just a discount store. They give millions to the poor. They get back in every fashion. But education is their passion.
Giveaholics, 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 Dollar General.
Woo!
We liked it, DBL, refined it, DBL, we like it.
Communication, that's their thing. For advertising, they're the bomb. Relations public and marketing. With DBL, you can't go wrong.
Well, DBL, resigned it, DBL, we thank you, DBL, refined it, DBL, we thank you.
Come on, Tyson!
their commitment to Tennessee. It's plain to see. They give big bucks to community. They are the bank who will lend and will bend in a bind. They are the bank
who will serve and deserve a high five.
One of the 100 best companies, they love to please. Ooh. They volunteer and give lots of grants. They take a chance.
Give the shirt, not the skirt,
or the pants. Ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah. People always saying the bank will rip you off. They go around spending all your dough.
Yeah.
Doyle, Phil, and Rita, you come through when we need ya. Test, and you always give your best. Hey,
Tennessee is one big spender.
When we need help, they're no pretenders.
Yeah,
they're the bank,
give the shirt,
not the pants. Oh yes, they are the bank. You give the shirt, not the skirt, or the pants. Tennessee is one big spender.
MP&F is a big spender.
General, they're a winner.
That DVL, they're no pretender.
The Tennessean has always been there.
We're out of time, so we'll just end here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, give them one more great big round of applause. Wow, what a great melody of music to honor the investment of our sponsors, and we thank you very much for that. I gotta bring it back down just a little bit. I wanted to throw in a hee hee, but I won't go there. Selfless, strong, wise, and visionary. Those are just a few words used to describe our next honoree, Laurie Gold Eskin.
Following in their footsteps. My mother was a lover of classical music and ballet and opera, and my father was a big band aficionado. So I got it from all sides, and they appreciated my music. They didn't tell me to turn off my rock and roll. How fortunate I was to find my husband, who has the most amazing family. They have been amazing role models to me, my mother and father-in-law. They have shown all of us, especially their boys, my husband Steve and his brother Jeff, and then in turn our children, how to give back to this community. 12 years ago, a good friend of mine, Kathy Gutto, came to me and wanted to know if I would help her co-chair and found the Nashville Jewish Film Festival, and it's still going today, and it's been a wonderful resource, I think, in the Jewish community and in the general community, and people look forward to it, and we keep growing it every year, and it's appreciated, and I love doing it. What gives me peace and joy is being with my animals, any animals, just walking and contemplating nature and just being around my family and my extended family. I laugh at a lot of things. I'm very goofy. My family is very goofy. Part of my philosophy of life is you gotta laugh at yourself and not take yourself too seriously. But you do have to take other people seriously. I'd like to think that people will remember me for loving the arts and that they get as much joy as I do and that they appreciate what it does for this community. A quote by Gandhi that recently I was reminded of was, be the change you want to see in the world, and I think that
says a lot and has a lot of meaning, and I try to aspire to that.
Congratulations, Lorraine. What a great impact you have had on the arts in Nashville. Our next honoree is Julie Wilson Walker. She is a science. She is a science and math guru and was the only woman in her graduate program in computer science. And today, she is called the Bridge Lady.
Remarkable women who have been honored in this way, and I felt very unworthy, but delighted and certainly honored to be recognized in this way. We're from Dallas originally. When we first got married, we moved to Houston, and I never made it my home. And I just thought, oh, I'll go home pretty soon, so I don't need to really get involved. And it was really a missed opportunity. Coming to Nashville, I thought, well, I'm going to make it my home, whether we're here for 6 months or 30 years, and it is our home. It just kind of happened accidentally. I taught some people how to play the card game bridge and decided to become an accredited bridge teacher, and really thought, well, if I could just find 8 people who might want to learn how to play bridge, I could teach them in my kitchen. And suddenly I had 50 people say, I want to take bridge lessons. And people on LinkedIn contact me all the time because I'm the bridge lady, and a lot of times they're structural engineers. And they want to be LinkedIn. I'm thinking, I don't build bridges, I teach bridge. So I learned so much being a member of the Junior League. That's where I met all my friends when I first moved here. I moved in and had instant 500 friends. It is 2,000 mostly professional women who are giving their skills and talents to the community. The volunteer experience that meant the most to me was when I was a tutor at Bethlehem Center working with some women getting their GED. The most touching moment to me was when a woman pulled out a gift she'd gotten from her grandson. And it was, a calculator. And she had no idea how to use it. And she was too embarrassed to ask her grandson, and I taught her how to use a calculator, and we just cried and cried and cried. It meant so much to her, just her self-respect. I've never clearly forgotten that moment and realized how rewarding it is to be a teacher. I'm most at peace being at home with our family, time around the dinner table with our boys, going to a movie as a family or out to dinner as a family. I absorb my energy from home. And then I think I go outside our home and expend it. Volunteer work is something that really rounds out, I think, a full life. People believe that, oh, I don't have time for volunteer work. Everybody has time for volunteer work. Everybody. Whether you've got 50 hours a week to give or 15 minutes, there is something that you can do in combination with another person that can really make an impact on somebody's life.
Congratulations, so many lives touched by Julie with her compassion and commitment to improving the quality of life for all. For 21 years, the YWCA has honored 124 extraordinary women, including those being honored this evening through the Academy for Women of Achievement. These women continue to leave a lasting impression.
Thank you.
We want to thank all of you for your commitment to the women in our community and to the YWCA. For those who were able to join us tonight, will you please stand so that we can recognize you? At the age of 29, our next honoree, Renata Soto, birthed the idea for Conexión Americas on a napkin. 10 years later, Conexión Americas has fundamentally altered the services and the landscape of South Nashville.
Thought of all the women who have had a lot of impact in my own path as a woman, as a mother, as a professional. People right here in Nashville like Candy Markman and Kaki Friscus-Warren and Megan Berry and Lisa Quigley. But in particular, I think of Mercedes Almaraz, a woman that I have known for now 10 years since we started Conexión Americas. She was in a small community where girls, after fourth grade, were going to work in the fields and only boys were given the opportunity to keep continuing their education. We celebrated with her last year that her oldest daughter graduated from high school, the first one in her family's generation to get to that point. She's a really great reminder of the immigrant spirit that has built this country and the amazing energy that parents like her invest. I grew up in San Jose, Costa Rica, and I love my country, my community, and I wanted to go somewhere else to study and then come back. And a very important decision in my life was when I fell in love with an American and I had to choose between redefining community and home. I remember a few years after our second child was born and the love that I felt for Nashville and remembering feeling like, this is my home. My advice to younger women is to first be very in touch with your convictions and your passion and your values. And from that, everything else flows. I think I am most proud of certainly being part of the team that created a nonprofit organization 10 years ago with a few resources, lots of ideas, and the ambition of creating a welcoming community. I am proud of the many families that we have helped buy a home, start a business, and like Mercedes, see their children graduate from high school and enroll in college. I am most excited about what is next and about the partners and the community that we have gathered around us to create a new community center on Nolensville Road at the gateway to Nashville's International District. I am excited about our collaboration with the Dowdy and the girls that will come to that community center and discover their potential. What makes me laugh are, that's a good one. I laugh a lot when I'm dancing. I love dancing, and so we have a house band at Conexión Americas, and that's my role. I'm a backup dancer. I hope that the lasting impression that I leave behind is that I was part of a movement that created the opportunity for people to come in front of one another and say, when I look into your eyes, I see myself. I see the same dreams, the same fears, the same humanity. There is a very relevant quote that summarizes that beautifully. It's a African proverb that says, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together.
Congratulations once again. You've got to admire such commitment to serve, truly an inspiration to follow your passion and to never give up. Our next honoree, Kathy Conninger, once led Kathy once led 700 Girl Scout leaders and volunteers chanting in unison, "The status quo has got to go," inspiring change and new direction for her organization.
When I got the call from the YWCA that I was part of this year's Academy for Women of Achievement, I was just thrilled. It was a major full circle for me. One, when I lived in Nashville 10 years ago, I attended all of these events and was just sitting in the audience being awed by the power of the women in this community. And then it also means a lot to me because I started my nonprofit career as an executive with the YWCA in Dallas, Texas, over 30 years ago, so to be honored by the Y really, really touches me. Women and girls have been the focus for my career always. Maybe partly growing up in an all-girl family, three daughters of my mom, and my dad was a great supporter of women. But I also, I was very interested early on in issues that affected women who had been raped and women who were trying to get elected to public office. And I love what I do. And I think leaders who love what they do bring both passion and authenticity to the work. There are lots of people, I think, who contribute to who I am and who I've become. Two people come to mind the most. One is my husband, Mike Williams. He has been absolutely my supporter. The other person that meant the most to me was Frances Hesselbein, who was a former CEO of Girl Scouts of the USA. She always saw something in me, and she was one of those women who cared about mentoring younger women. The last 8 years have really been profound to me as the national CEO of Girl Scouts of the USA. It's the largest organization for girls in the world, and I think its mission to be the best leadership experience for girls is incredibly important to this nation. The mission is to build girls of courage, confidence, and character who make the world a better place. What makes me laugh? My husband telling me a joke. he writes great story songs with a bit of humor. So I know I can always count on Mike when the going gets rough to come up with a song that's just gonna, bust right through my serious mood. I wanna leave the world much more aware of the power of girls and the need for gender balance in leadership. A favorite quote of mine comes from Julia Gordon Lowe, who's the founder of Girl Scouting, and she was an amazing visionary. She founded Girl Scouting before women even had the right to vote in 1912. In one of her earliest handbooks, there was a quote from her saying, "What a jolly, wondrous working thing a group of girls all forging ahead together can be."
Again, congratulations, and things really do come full circle from her first job at the YW to being honored today. These women that you've seen are truly amazing. They are so accomplished yet unique in their enormous contributions to this community. They have come as far as Costa Rica, embraced diversity and opportunity, and through their countless acts of service have touched lives and left lasting impressions. I am humbled by their contributions and look forward to seeing what each of them has next coming up in our community. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the YWCA, I am proud to present the Academy for Women of Achievement, Class of 2012. As you stand, I will welcome them up on stage. Kathy Kloninger. Laurie Goldeskin. Stacy A. Garrett. Renata Soto. Mary Schlater Stum. And Julie Wilson Walker. Congratulations once again to the 2012 Academy for Women of Achievement honorees. We also want to thanks again to First Tennessee and all of our generous sponsors and to everyone for joining us. What an honor it is to be here and a great honor for me to be asked to be a part of this great celebration once again. As we end the program tonight, we've got one more quick look at our honorees in a slightly different light. Good night, enjoy your dinner, everybody, and be safe going home.
I have a rescue dog, Leo, who just this morning got up on the counter and ate 4 pieces of baklava.
I majored in political science.
I finished my master's degree from the University of, I gotta start over there.
The answer to that is easy. It's the.
That's a good one.
You're Julie, right?
Yes.
Okay. Julie, take one.
Do not put this part in. It's the one. The Bachelor. Is it The Bachelor? The Hangover.
Oh, what do you say? Take Chris.
What makes me laugh are. Oh, what makes me laugh?
Yeah, I tell jokes, but sometimes I don't quite know what I'm doing.
Let's see. I laugh when I'm under pressure.
I'm very goofy. My family is very goofy.
Mary, you do not understand that joke. Do not tell it again.
Well, what brings me peace is, what brings me peace?
I guess
I would really like to skydive.
I want to skydive.
I love salsa.
Can we cut it? Because that's going to make me cry.